James Lankford was such a big supporter of the previous bipartisan immigration bill and the fact that we saw it die.
And that bill wasn't the only border bill to die in recent years. I asked Representative Stephanie Bice, who's running for re-election in House District 5, about gridlock at the Capitol.
Look, that's sort of how Congress works. I mean, if you look at the founding fathers did not want things to happen quickly, and that's for a reason. I think we want to address some of these important issues, but coming to consensus can be challenging.
Her opponent says the time to get something done is now.
I think that we need to get out of our own way, and we just need to do things for the effectiveness and the purpose that leaving our border open is a national security problem.
Bice is the Republican incumbent and says Trump-era policies that the Biden administration removed need to come back before they can make progress anywhere else.
That has increased the number of people illegally coming into the country. We can't address the immigration issue until you secure the border.
Her Democratic challenger, Madison Horn, tells me fixing immigration problems needs to be part of the solution.
We haven't updated our immigration process since post-World War II, and we need to understand as a country, immigration is actually a good thing, and it helps us build a very strong workforce here in the United States.
Bice says if those Trump policies are returned, she wants to see immigration updated too.
First and foremost, you know, when you're looking at people that want to come here to work, there's a cap on the number of individuals. What can we do to increase that cap?
But both candidates expressed major concerns with immigration policy after an Afghan man living in Oklahoma City was arrested for an alleged Election Day terror plot.
What we do need to evaluate is this was a downfall of the fact that there wasn't an appropriate vetting process.
Stephanie Bice says that's something she's digging for more information on.
What I see as a huge failure, though, is the fact that when I asked for an additional briefing from the FBI, they ran it up the flagpole to the DOJ, and the Department of Justice actually denied me getting any additional information about how the individual came into the country, whether or not he was vetted.
Colby Terrell, KOCO 5 News.